Okay, this is my agenda. First of all, I will introduce about API management, our WSO2 API management vision and the solution architecture of the API management platform and the product features that we have and also the capabilities. And at the end of the presentation, I'm planning to have a small demonstration about the WSO2 API management solution as well. Okay, first of all, let's talk about what is API economies. So you all know that today we are in a data-centric world, and basically we all of us driven by data, right? So, so because of that, the huge amount of data and also a huge amount of devices, which makes the connected world has pushed APIs to the forefront of the API, forefront of the IT transformation of the organizations. So because of that important thing, so you can see that organizations can internally reuse and share what the, their data and their resources using APIs. And also that APIs also provide an opportunity for the organization or the companies, for the external developers to innovate based on the organization data and the based on their data. So it's an asset. Data is an asset for an organization. In modern world, that assist has a value on mobile, in terms of mobile application development as well, driven by the need to the consumer, I mean the internal data from app, mobile applications. So that having an API plays a major role in order to develop a mobile application development as well. These kind of requirements simply build new channels and ecosystem for organizations to develop in their business ecosystem. So this picture simply depicts what I have described in my previous slide. So you can see that we have business data here. On top of that, you can have your services, and those data and services can be exposed through APIs, and there are many more attributes attached to the APIs as well. Right. So, when it comes to managing APIs, exposing enterprise data is not a very easy task. It's always challenging. So, you know that we have to expose our enterprise data or the processes through the internet or through, let's say, internet to internal or customers. Because of that, there is always a risk which you have to bear as an organization. But you can't take that risk because just because of exposing your exposing your data to the outside. That's where this managing API comes into the play. Simply, you can take over the control of the APIs by implementing several security features and SLAs, authentication, and all of them are security related stuff. And also on top of that, you can monitor and monetize the APIs as well, which will ultimately give you some revenue about the from the APIs or the data that you have. That's how you can make money, or that's how it become an asset of your organization. Okay. So this is the place where WSO2 API manager comes into the picture, right? So you can simply leverage our platform or the WSO2 API management solution in a way that in a secured and in a by simply applying security, monetization and monitoring, and also enhancing the performance of your data or the backend APIs that you have. So it's simply 100% open source product. Back, and you can see that I have mentioned here several points. It is simply backed by high performance gateway, which is which handles 100 million requests per day, and also there are multiple features in it. I can show you during my demonstration. So it includes social enablement as well, which is nowadays very popular. The social networking is very popular. So we have integrated that capabilities into our API management platform. And also, as I mentioned earlier, one of our main concerns was is also security. So we have implemented single sign-on by leveraging a social enablement with the security. And also we have named as strong performer in this space, I mean in this API management space in 2014. Okay. So this is the capabilities that we expose or that we handle through our solution, API management solution. We can simply expose APIs for public consumption, and also you can use APIs to the internal consumption as well. For an instance, let's say you are running your organization has a database with information with employees. You don't need to expose your employee details to your competitors or any other third party, right? That data might use by your own another department. Let's say HR department or the accounts department might want that data, but it definitely you don't need it. You don't need to expose them to the outside. So in that case, those APIs can be consumed inside your organization. But there are situations that you have to expose data to the outside world. For an instance, you know that Amazon and Google right now, they are exposing some of their services to the external parties through the APIs. On top of those two scenarios, we have also control access to the cloud services as well, which is managed and secured to the applications through the cloud. So when it comes to API management vision, our platform can basically, so let's say you have created API. It is, if you have and create an API already, you can host it in application server or data services server. And now when you want to publish your API to the outside world, simply our platform can help you. So you can see that what as a consumer you have to do is just find and subscribe to the API that you need. For an instance, it's something like Google Play or Apple's iStore. Simply you log into the Google Play and you search for the APIs or the applications you want, and you just download it. Something like that. I will show you how it works during my demonstration. And when it comes to monitoring and monetization, as I explained earlier, you can do these monitoring and monetization aspects as well using our management platform. Okay, so this is the very high level architecture of our platform. You can see that The core product is API Manager, which consists several components. And we do recommend to have a separate analytics component as well, because we have to segregate their functionalities to handle the performance. And based on the requirement, it can be further extended using other components such as enterprise service bus, identity server, and governance registry. Those are not actually required, but it's totally depend on the requirement, because you can simply scale up a platform or the solution either horizontally or vertically using this something like this, right? Okay. So we have identified an ecosystem model to our API management product. It has three core components as API creator, publisher, and consumer. Creator is the one who simply developed the API by understanding a business or a technical requirement, and based on that he develops a kind of service or an API which can be published through our API publisher. When it comes to the API publisher, it simply publish the APIs, and it encourage consumers to subscribe to their particular APIs. So as a publisher, he can determine what are the security levels that particular API needs or requires, and also the monetization aspects, such as what is the maximum throttling level which can be handled or which should be handled through his API. Such things can be handled through the API, and I will show you those stuff during the demonstration. And the last part is this API consumer. As I said, it's basically API subscriber who simply needs fulfill a particular requirement using an API. So he just has to search for a particular API which fulfill his requirement and subscribe. So these are the four major components or the architecture we have in our product. So as you can see that we have segregate all four components separately. So there is a separate segment called API publisher and API store, and this is the API gateway which I was talking about, which has very high performance. This is a very high performance gateway, and on top of that we have a key manager to handle the security. And besides that, there is another segment for monitoring and analytics part. So this is the very high level architecture of the API gateway, which simply do the all the transactions, which handles the basic transactions, and also the you can see that there's a key management. We have separated key manager server for the security aspects. And there's another very important point of our platform is multi-tenancy. So our product can simply create multiple domains. For an instance, you can see that you can have a API store with different languages, but at the end of the day, you can expose them as a central store. At the end of the day, you can expose it at a central store. So this is very this is very important feature in the industry in today's world. So on top of this multi-tenancy, our API manager store can be customized based on the requirement or the based on your company company's logo or the whatever the color theme. We have this all our user interfaces are simply created using a technology called jQuery. So you can by it's very similar to JavaScript. You can customize as you want your user interfaces as well. And when I talk about the customization, as I said, based on your requirement, you can simply add or the simply scale this product either horizontally or vertically by adding more and more components to handle the API transaction load. For an instance, if you want have thousands of if you want to deal with thousands of transactions per second, you might need to have a separate enterprise service bus at some point. And also, if you need to have a security, a very advanced level of security, you might need to add identity server at some point. But as I said earlier, it's totally based on your requirement, and you can do it once you are completely done with the basic API management solution. So this is the scalable deployment architecture. You can see that as I explained earlier, it's very clearly segregated, and API publisher and API store can be separated from the API gateway and the key management. So if your transaction level is very high, you can have multiple API gateways, and still you can adapt to API store, one a single node of API store and API publisher. So as I said, it's again based on the requirement. And finally, this is the recommendation deployment, what we call it API facade pattern, which simply separate API management layer and the mediation layer and the service layer. So you can have all the stuff all together, but we do not recommend to do that. So this is the recommended way of implementing enterprise solution using our API management platform. So now I will jump into the demonstration. So up to now, do you have any questions? I think I can answer. Yeah. Yep. So So for an instance, if you are a creator of the API, right? So you can use our application server or ESB or the DSS server to publish those services, right? So then that can be published through the API manager, right? So I think that might.
There are some contents that the company maybe doesn't know if they are sensible content, mm-hmm. if the company can or cannot share, and how does WSO2 help the company on deciding what to share and what not to share?
So we can't determine that, right? So it totally depends on the organization. It's an organization requirement. They should know that what are the data that they should expose and they should not expose, right? So it's a different thing, right? but we can control the, you know, we can add security on top of the API calls, right? But that what you want to expose and what you do not expose, it's a different thing, right? It should be determined by the, yeah, by the company, right? Okay. Right. So this is our API publisher, right? This is the place that you can publish your APIs, and I will log in as admin. And you can see I have already added several APIs, and I will show you by adding one API. I think you can see it, right? Okay. So I will show you how to add an API. This is a very high level demonstration about this API manager product. First, you have to give the API name and the context, and you can add the version number of the particular API, and from this particular place, the visibility, you can determine whether it's public or public or either visible to only a particular domain, or it can be restricted by roles as well. You know, the roles, it can be either to you can define users and roles, so you can restrict the visibility of these APIs to this, to a set of roles as well, right? And also you can determine what are the domains that you can expose this expose your APIs. And so for this demonstration, I will make it as public. And if you have an image or icon, simply you can add the icon as well. So here, using the description area, you can give a small description about your API. And that you can add tags. So these tags can is very helpful once you for the subscribers, so they can search their APIs using these tags. So let's say something like rain, sun, or something like that. These tags will be published in the API store after we publish at the end of the day, right? So this is the place you can add URL patterns. So I will add all the basic HTTP methods here, right? So you can see that I in the first phase or the in the, during in the design phase, I have already added basic information about my API. Now what I have to do is either save or I can go to implement, which takes me to the next level. And here at this point, I have to give the give to the endpoint. You can select what is the type of endpoint using this drop down, and here you have to give the production endpoint or where the exact API is, the location of the exact API. So I have a predefined API with me. Let me get it. And you can check whether the validity of your production endpoint. So if you have any sandbox or any test environment, you can add the endpoint of this sandbox as well. And on top of that, we have another options as well using WSL file and WGL. You can use those as well, right? So here I have several options here. If I save it, this will simply just save it, and you can see there's another option called deploy prototype. So if you select this deploy prototype, what will happen is this API will be published as a trial API, right? So I, if I go to my our store, you can I'll describe during when I talk about this API store. You can see that there's a separate tab called prototype APIs. I have already at one prototype APIs. So if I just click deploy prototype, this API will be published into this prototype API segment. So it so users do not need to subscribe to these prototype APIs to get the things done using this API. It's a simply trial API. So as a developer or as a publisher, you might it might be handy. So you can at the first stage, so you can get the customer feedbacks about your API. Just make it available commercially. So now I just let it. I'm going to publish this as a true the true product. So if I go to manage, now I'm going to the third phase or the last phase of this API publishing. Right here, you can see that this is very important, right? So this is the place that you can determine. So as the publisher, you can determine the number of calls that you can, a customer or subscriber can call, or your subscriber can call or use your API. So this is totally customizable. I will show you how to do it. So for this demonstration, I have just created bronze, gold, and silver, and unlimited tiers. So as a publisher of the API, I'm going to give all the four options for my subscribers to select. So once I explain the subscribe or the API store, I will show you what how this can be used by a by a subscriber. So basically that's all what I have to do is as an API publisher. Okay, that's it. So you can see that now it's published, and this is the summary of the API which I just published. So if you want to make any changes, you can edit, and if you want to make if you want to control the life cycle of the product, you can do it by do it here. So we have implemented several life cycle models. So simply you can determine what stage your API should be. So if you just created and if you do not need to publish it to the outside, or the if you do not need to subscribers if you do not need subscribers to subscribe your API, so you just you can just keep it create. And if you can see that there's something called prototype, if you make it prototype, what will happen is it's again it will published to the prototype segment, and as I make it as published, so now it will be there in the API store. So its subscribers can simply subscribe to the APIs. And if you need to, if let's say if you have a newer version of the API, you can deprecate the existing API. And if you need to retire, or if you completely remove your API from the API store, you can select API, you can select simply retired. So in that case, it will not be available for subscribers to subscribe, and even for the existing users, they can't use your API if you make it deprecate. So simply it controls your APIs from cradle to grave. And it's very, and another main feature that we have implemented in API publisher is statistics. So as an API publisher, you might be interested about the usage of your APIs. So you can see that I have all existing two APIs. I have already two APIs there in my API store. So this is the usage of my existing APIs. So simply you can customize the these graphs as you want. So now I will move to the API store. So first, as an subscriber, what I have to do is just log in, and now you can see my the just created weather API is now in the API store, and it's available for subscription. So as the subscription now a subscriber, and now I'm going to subscribe for the weather API, and this is the application. This is my application, and you can see that the tiers which I was talking about. So if I select bronze tier, this I can only it allows only one request per minute. This is customizable. You can determine the duration and the number of requests according to your requirement. So if I go to gold level, it allows me 20 requests per minute, right? So simply this handles a kind of security aspect as well. So for this, I will select demo. I will select silver tier, which allows me 5 requests per minute, right? So on top of that, you can see that you can rate these APIs according to your experience about on the API, and also you can simply make your comments in Facebook or in Google Plus like that. You can make your or you can simply send email to your friend, and those aspects as also covered in this API store. So now I will subscribe to my API, the weather API. And once I subscribe, I will get access token, which corresponds to this particular application. This is a OAuth2 based token, and you can determine the validity period of the token as well. If you regenerate it, you can get a new access token as well. So I will just invoke this API. We have before invoking that, I will explain the tabs we have introduced in API store. So you can see that in APIs, it shows us all the available APIs for the subscribers, and when it goes to prototype APIs, it only shows the prototype APIs. You don't, as a subscriber, you don't need to subscribe to try it out these prototype APIs. And if you go to the My Subscriptions, it will show you what are the APIs that you have already subscribed. And as a subscriber, you can see the statistics as well. So there are a couple of statistics published here, and there's another important feature. There is a forum feature which you can simply express your experience and your opinions through this forum inside the API manager store itself. Right, on top of that, we have an integrated REST client which you can simply test the API. So this is the place that I have to give my auth token, and I have to pass it as a HTTP header. And so I have to hit the production URL.
Motorista.
So here I'm going to. Get the London weather. Let's see. Okay, so you can see that here I'm getting the current weather of London. So likewise, you can use the API manager or the API manager solution to expose your organization or the company data or the valuable data to the internal or external customers using our platform. So basically that's it. I think if you have any questions, I can answer. Right? Okay then, thank you very much.